The growing population with increased activities, particularly industrial, commercial, infrastructure development. I mean, it goes without saying that we will need a lot more support from you. And I said, how can I have my friend as MP? And this Oshogbo man keeps getting 24-hour electricity, and he hardly gets any. Well, in the capital, we do get maybe about 11, 12 hours. But in majority of our communities, we're caught up. And it's something that I know we have to tackle at the level of BEDC. But if these various injections you have mentioned come into the state, the Benin Akure 330 kVA installation, and then the improved Oshogbo Akure and 132 to Ekiti also improves, then some of the things that we need, particularly for our government establishments, and then for our street lights, can be put on that direct supply, whilst the domestic users can go on capacity that is lower than that. And that's what I really want to plead for. As per the broader perspective that you have shared with us, both at the colloquium and now this afternoon, I think it's important for us to keep getting this enlightenment. It would be great to have it at the level of the Governors Forum. So you should come maybe to our retreat. You know, we have more new governors coming in. So there's a retreat for governors, I believe, April 28th to May 1st. I'll talk to the DG, because electricity is a big issue for all of us. I don't know any state, even Kebbi, which appears to be doing better than others now with permanent supply of electricity there, they still have issues. So I believe it would be great to hear from you at that level. We keep harassing the minister because he used to be one of us, so we can knock his head constantly, but he still does not give us as much as he would love to. TCN has to help us out, and the BEDC have to also help us out.
What I want to give you is that, you know, we supply electricity at high voltage. It is the distribution companies that distribute the electricity. But at high voltage, the supply to Ekiti, I think in the whole of Ekiti state, as of now, we have one transmission interface, which is the Ado Ekiti. And I think Ado Ekiti get their supply from Oshogbo. But we are working to complete the 330 kV line from Oshogbo, another 330 kV line from Oshogbo to Akure, then Akure to Akure to Benin. Now that line has reached advanced stage. That was why I met the governor of Ofondo there today, because we need some support from him. So once we finish that line, our intention is to start supplying Ekiti from Akure, so that we will now have redundancy. It means if there's a problem between Akure and Oshogbo, we now have another way of supplying Ado Ekiti. And the current capacity of Ado Ekiti is not exhausted by what we have. But you know, our plan is to make every federal capital, state capital, a 330 kV substation. So we are looking at two options of creating a 330 in Ado Ekiti. One is that we are looking at the possibility of using the Mambila project, because the Mambila has a 700 kilometers of 330. We want to radiate the line actually from Mambila to Makodi, Makodi to Ayamba, Ayamba to Ajaputa. We are thinking that we can move it from Ajaputa to Ado Ekiti. Some of our engineers are saying it doesn't make economic sense. So there's a debate on this one. So we are looking at other options of turning in, turn out one of those lines. But there are some lines that pass not too far from Adoekiti. The line that moves from Gamu to Oshogbo, we can turn out that line. The other option that we can do is to take a 330 from Oshogbo, Akure 330 substation, and come and link it to the line that go to Gamu. So that we put a 330 in Adoekiti. So these are the options we are looking at, but we are very serious about it, especially given the fact that you are our friend and we have to support Ekiti State, sir. So you are welcome to our office.
Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube for more information on the Transmission Company of Nigeria, TCN.